in the world so cold. H-Town got a nigga so throw.
Who's got the biggest chunk in LA? Big Chunk.
Done.
That's my time right here. Road Show Radio. I think I'll be back next week. I think. Until then, y'all have a blessed one. Big Chunk's RB turntable. Thank you.
We bring you that heat.
Check it out.
Hot new music.
Yo,
and throwbacks.
This is
San Diego's number one for internet radio.
Let me show you how it goes.
WorldTuneRadio.com.
The views and opinions expressed on the following radio program are those of the hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of WorldTunedRadio.com, its management, or other hosts or advertisers. The shows found on WorldTunedRadio.com can promote any lifestyle, belief, religion, political affiliation, or other personal practice. The following program is for entertainment purposes only.
Hello, 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 and welcome to the Soul Suite with Marcus DeWell. I'm your host, Marcus, here with the gorgeous, beautiful Miss Catalina.
Oh, I love it when you say that.
How are you doing today?
I'm good. Happy New Year to all listeners.
Happy New Year's to everybody out there.
First
show of the year. Yep. Yes. We always take longer than everyone else. Why do we always do that?
Well, because we like that break.
I know. It's nice. It's very nice.
Although we love spending our Sundays with you guys.
Yes, it's always nice to spend Sundays with all you guys around
That's
the world,
right.
around the globe, loving everything and doing everything. So did you have a nice holiday season?
I sure did. It was great.
It was great. It was really nice.
It was relaxing. It wasn't over the top.
Yeah, I can't. That's boring. I need to go over the top.
You need
that's
to have something
me.
Going
I,
on.
Nah, yeah. We already talked about this. Balance is not good for me.
He's
I
not
hate
a balanced
balance.
Person.
No. I tip the scales.
You do. It's all or nothing.
All or nothing.
All or nothing, baby.
So we have an interesting show for you guys today. Yes. And if you guys can see them in the studio right now, we have a great, great, great artist in the building. You guys are going to love her music. I'm not introducing you guys to her yet, but she can wave at you.
What
She's right there on the camera right there.
What
hey, you guys want to give her a call? You guys want to talk to her in the building? Give us a call, 760-967-8863. That's 760-967-8863. We're going to get to know her a little bit better, listen to her music, and just do all those types of things. Right, Miss Catalina?
That's right.
All right, so you ready to get this going?
I'm absolutely ready. Let's
all
go.
All right, let's get this show on the road. You listen to the Soul Suite with Marcus DeWell on WorldTuneRadio.com.
Coming at you like a dark horse. Hey! Are you
there's no going back.
A beast, I call her karma. She eats your heart out like Jeffrey Dahmer. Be careful, try not to lead her on. Shawty heart is on steroids, cause her love is so strong. You may fall in love when you meet her. If you get the chance, you better keep her. She's sweet as pie, but if you break her heart, she turn cold as a freezer. That fairy tale ending with a knight in shiny armor. She can be my sleeping beauty, I'm gonna put her in a coma. Damn, I think I love her. Shot it so bad, I sprung and I don't care. She rap me like a roller coaster, turned the bedroom into a fair. Her love is like a drug, I was trying to hit it and quit it. But little mama so dope, I messed around and got addicted.
So you wanna play?
You call
that stunt now. Let's just be real.
Let's just be honest. Let's just be real. Yeah, let's just be honest.
Let's just be real.
Let's just be honest. We all know the deal. So let's just be honest. Let's just be real.
Welcome.
To the eighth wonder of the world.
This is WorldTunedRadio.com.
Back in the most amazing way.
Officially here.
So crazy right now.
On WorldTunedRadio.
WorldTunedRadio.com.
You listen to Soul Sweet Marcus Well, who's gorgeous, beautiful Miss Catalina.
Why do you always give me that?
Because you always play the song. It's just everybody knows that this song is coming up next. I mean, it's always the same song. Yeah, you're right. You never disappoint. You never ever disappoint. Routine, Catalina.
You know, I need that, though.
All right. I told you guys we have a great, great show for you tonight. The person that you see in the building right now is San Diego's own singer-songwriter, currently working on her debut album, EP, Intersections. I want to introduce you guys to the beautiful Miss Evan Diamond in the building.
Hi. Aww.
How are you doing?
I'm happy to have you here.
I'm doing really good. Thank you.
Thank you very much for coming in.
Yeah.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah.
Okay, so, hey, first off, Is Evan Diamond just your is it your real name, right?
It's a shortened version.
Okay.
My full name is Evan Diamond Goldberg, but we just shortened it.
Okay.
Just
all right.
It's your stage name.
I know, but it's perfect though.
Yeah,
it sounds
perfect.
Really good. It's a great name.
Thank you.
A very, very good name.
I really like it.
So you're local here in San Diego, right?
Yeah, I'm from Canada, but I moved here 2 years ago.
Canadians always have the best artists. Why is that? Why does Canada
have
the best artists?
Too.
They have the best artists, the best actors, the best singers. You know what? What's going on up there? What's really going on up there?
I don't know. There must be something in the water.
Where in Canada are you from?
Alberta.
So okay.
Just above Montana.
Love it.
Mm-hmm. That's cool. So tell us a little about Evan Diamond. Tell us a little about what makes up Evan Diamond.
Well, I mean, I'm a musician at heart. I've always wanted to do music, and I'm just me. I take in so much stuff, and I'm a singer-songwriter.
Uh-huh.
And I've been writing music for, I would say, my whole life. I started writing more seriously a couple years ago when I was still in university, just to deal with emotions I was going through. And, but I've been writing my whole life. I remember back in grade five, yeah. I wrote this song. My parents knew nothing about it. I performed it in front of my entire class.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And
that takes some guts, though, at that age.
I couldn't believe that I did it still. To this day,
really?
I don't understand how I did it. And
when you
everybody
at that age,
loved it.
It's so scary to do that. You had it
Were
natural.
You nervous at all?
You know, I always liked being the center of attention. So
that's got to be it.
I love talking in front of people. And I was really nervous. But once I started singing, it was like, okay, I'm here.
You're natural.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's just been what I wanted to do.
So you started at the age of five on your own, basically, because you're the one that wrote a song, you said, right?
When I was in grade five.
When you were in grade five. Sorry. Yeah.
I can't remember how old
So
I was then,
you started on your own. Was there any influences? Did you have is your mom sang or your family sang? How did that come out?
I come from a family very interested in music. My dad and I grew up, I didn't grow up with my dad. But my dad would always play the Beatles, the Who, classic rock in the car all the time, whereas my mom had me growing up on Carole King, James Taylor, Carly Simon, and then I was also listening to popular music. So all of that, all those genres just became ingrained in me, and I just loved music. I loved what it could do to people and how it could move people and inspire them.
Do you think those genres have a style in your type of music, or do you have a specific genre, or you're all over the board?
I think I garner a lot of influences from a bunch of different genres, indie, pop, rock, even R&B, a little bit of country. Like, I like to take in everything and make it my own thing.
That's cool. That's cool. That's what makes an artist. I mean, you have to have your own independent.
It's like thing. If you were a painter and you wanted to use different mediums to make your art. It's the same thing.
Right.
It gives it more depth.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So where do you get your inspiration from? I mean, you did say Carole King. Is that some of the people that you've looked back on? And who is your favorite artist?
Oh, wait a minute. No, she's 20 years old. What does she know about Carole King?
Well, her father played all that music,
that's
right?
Cool. Cool.
I mean, you usually get your inspiration from your someplace where you've listened to this stuff.
Yeah.
So who's your favorite artist?
My favorite artists of all time are the Beatles.
Okay.
But I'd have to say my biggest inspiration when it comes to my songwriting is Carole King. She just,
So you're an old soul right there, huh?
Yeah, I mean, she just tells stories with her music, and that's always been my goal, is to go in and engage the listener and take them on this journey with my music, just like Carole did.
Oh,
there's a lot of artists out there right now whose music does not mean anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I hate those songs, honestly.
Well, they're repetitive.
I mean,
they have no depth.
I mean,
to them
and
at
there's
all.
Nothing. It's not a roller coaster ride of a story.
Right.
I feel that when it comes to a song, I want you to take me on a ride from beginning to end.
Mm-hmm.
And it sounds like that's the way your music is. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's what I try to do. I mean, I like songs that I can just like dance to
yes,
and stuff.
Yeah.
But when it comes to my own music, yeah, I want people to feel good, and I want them to be able to dance to some of my songs.
Uh-huh.
But I also want them to be able to just sit and listen and go, I'm not alone. She knows what I'm talking about. I've been there, you know?
You know, one of my favorite artists was Jewel. Is
mm-hmm.
Jewel. And you remind me a lot of her.
Okay,
just
in
your mannerisms and your voice reminds me of her. And
thank
she started
you.
Out here in San Diego, too.
Awesome.
In a car. She lived in a car.
She lived in a car?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
that's
okay.
Great.
Well,
and sang coffee houses and...
That's what you got to do. That's
yeah,
what you got to do.
Right.
I mean, if it worked for her, then it can work for anybody,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. Yeah.
But you got to have that drive, right?
Yeah.
So what is it that pushes you to let your music be heard out there?
Music touches me in such a deep place. And I want it to do that to other people. Listening to artists like Carole King, even like current artists like Ed Sheeran, Demi Lovato, they push me to want to be at that level and to be able to connect with the audience, like their music connected with me. But I also have so much support from my friends and my family. My friend Kendall is here in the studio with us today.
What's up, Kendall? How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Doing good. So tell us a little about Evan.
She's fantastic. She's like one of the best friends I've ever had. She's amazing.
Loyal to the end, right?
Heck yeah. Ride or die right here.
Where did you first hear her sing, and how'd you get into her music?
Oh, I don't remember.
What's that?
Was that what it was?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to one of her shows down in San Diego. I think that was the first time that I heard
that
it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, and then it was just something like, I gotta meet this girl. That's what it's at?
No, we were friends for a while,
oh,
and
okay.
She invited me to one of her shows. I was like,
okay. So when you're doing a show, do you feel a little nervous before you go on stage? Or how does that work?
Yeah.
I mean, being 20 years old, do you feel that it affects you differently? Or are you just bouncing around, just happy already, just jump on stage, do whatever you want?
I'm nervous, like, leading up to it. I get butterflies, and I'm like, oh, please don't forget the words, please don't forget the words. But as soon as I am on stage and I start playing, I'm like, okay, I'm home. This is what I'm supposed to do.
Okay.
So the nerves go away for the most part. I get more nervous like talking in between
mm-hmm.
songs than I do when I'm playing them. I'm like, keep the audience engaged, please.
Now, do you play instruments too?
Yeah, I play the guitar as well.
Okay, so you're up on the stage with your guitar.
Mm-hmm.
And that's your crutch, no?
It is. Well, probably sometimes it is.
Sometimes
yeah, because I started playing like open mic nights and everything, and it was just me and my guitar.
Right.
So right now, it's funny, the couple times I've played with a band, it's so different for me to then put my guitar away and have to like stand there. But, I mean,
it's your security blanket.
Exactly.
And I think that's a good thing. I mean, if you can sing the way we've heard your music and you know you can sing, then I don't think you have any crutches, whatever. I mean, you can have whatever you want. You can have a ukulele up there and it'll make a
difference. Thank you.
So songwriting, let's get into your songwriting.
Okay.
So Do you have this secret place where you go to write your songs, or do you have to play? Where do you get your where do you go to write songs? Where do you mentally and physically? Is there somewhere where you go the to write songs?
It's different for every song. I've written songs literally, I pulled over on the side of the road and just had to write like half of a song. But most of my songs are just me sitting in my room or me with my parents brainstorming and coming up with melodies. I don't have a way I write every single song that's the same, but you know, I might get an idea from a quote and then I just hunker down. I'm like, okay, this is it. This is what I'm going to do. It depends.
Are they written about somebody?
Some of them are. I have some that are based off of personal experiences, but I like to write about other love stories and quotes and
even you like to keep it more positive than negative though, right?
Yeah. I like something that the Beatles always did that I really admired was they could take even a breakup song and still make it upbeat and fun.
Mm-hmm.
And not make you wallow in the self-pity.
So speaking of breakup songs, we're going to play one of your songs called Bad Guy.
Oh.
Can you explain a little bit about this song?
So Bad Guy was one of my songs written about a personal experience. And it's something I think lots of people have gone through where you argue with a friend or a partner and they want to blame you. You're the bad guy. And I'm a very sarcastic person, so I wrote that from a very tongue-in-cheek sort of state of mind. And when I wrote it, I would just think of like that old-time movie villain, just like you're sitting on the edge of their seats waiting for what's going to happen
right,
next.
They're going and like this.
Yeah, exactly. And I just, I wrote it and I wanted people to just be able to immerse themselves in the auditory, using their auditory sense and imagery and everything, and just really feel that, oh, I'm the bad guy. Okay, I'm the guy with the mustache and the top hat, you know, tying the damsel in distress to the railroad tracks.
All right, so here we go. Introduce this song to everybody out there.
So this song is called Bad Guy, and it is going to be featured on my debut EP, Intersections, and I hope you guys like it.
To hurt you, but you did so much worse. Kicked me when I'm down, baby, you're driving my hearse. If I could fix it all and take it back, I don't think I would. Cause I'm finally happy it's all misunderstood. Get ready to scream.